What are your hobbies now? Like, what do you like now?
Business.
Get water.
opportunities everywhere. Do you know that Uber Eats is about to enter the Nigerian market? I don't even know if they have already entered. But according to marketandresearch.com, the Nigerian food and grocery retail market is worth over $45.7 billion, representing a compound annual growth rate of 5.8% between 2016 and 2020. Hello guys, it's Mike Irumaka here, and in today's video, I'm going to be having a conversation with a wonderful young entrepreneur who's trying to disrupt the grocery industry, and let's say the logistics industry, with bicycles. His name is Nnamdi Clinton, and without much talks, let's dive right into today's video. But wait, please and please not forget to smash the like button and also hit the subscribe button for us to get to 10,000 subscribers, and also for the YouTube algorithm to recommend this video to more people. And let's dive right into today's video. Let's go.
What's up, man? Introduce yourself.
Alright, so I'm Clinton, Nnamdi Clinton. I'm a brand strategist and a marketing consultant down here in Nigeria.
Okay.
So
yeah, you're creating for me with states.
Definitely.
So what's up, bro? I want to share your journey with us, because I see the stuff you're doing with the brand doctor. That's your brand name. Yeah,
that's my brand
name. Yeah, and then you now decide to go into the logistics. You're playing in the logistics field, am I?
Yes.
So basically, just explain what you're currently doing with Simba, because you're wearing
Right. So basically, I'm a marketing consultant. I'm a brand strategist. So I help brands scale on the internet.
Yeah.
So and I'm also in school, final year, about to graduate.
Yeah.
Then I also kicked off the brand called Simba. So I won't really call it a logistics brand.
Yeah.
But I will call it a convenience store.
Okay.
So the aim of Simba is actually to bring convenience to people's doorstep. So we want people to stay at their doorstep, and then we want to bring Simba to them.
Okay.
So what we do is that we help you shop your groceries from any market in Imo State or Nigeria and get it down to your doorstep.
Yeah.
Now, but it does not just stop there. We also help you shop meals, already cooked meals from any restaurant in any in your locality and bring it down to your doorstep. So it's more like a game changer in the whole logistics business. So and then we offer exclusively meal and grocery delivery services.
So what's brought about this idea? Do you just wake up one day and say you want to go and start bringing convenience to people with Simba, or like what brought about the idea of Simba?
Okay, Simba came from this. So at a point, I was actually I was just somewhere.
Yeah.
So I was looking for a way whereby someone can just go and buy for me from the market and get to my doorstep.
Yeah.
While I just, because I was tired. Like I was so tired. So I tried looking for people around. I could not find any person.
Yeah.
In Imo State in Nigeria.
Yeah.
Then one thing about me that I appeal to excellence. So I saw a few of them, but then they weren't, like say, up to my standard, because they weren't branded enough. No, I have the eye of aesthetics.
Yeah.
So they were not really branded to my taste.
Yeah.
And they were just still in the mediocre level.
Yeah.
So I was like, okay, how about I bring up a platform? Actually, Simba came from a transition.
Okay.
It was formerly EasyChop. From EasyChop, it came to EasyGo.
Yeah.
From EasyGo, I was like, oh, let me integrate Lion King theme into
Simba.
So that was where I thought of Mufasa and Simba.
Yeah, yeah.
I said, okay, let me browse online. Is any brand with this using this name Simba?
Yeah.
No one was using it. I said, okay, let me use Simba. So from there, I had to implement strategies from my own expertise.
Yeah.
Brought a team, and executing the perfect big picture.
So before Simba, now you're also into branding at the moment, right?
Yes,
and marketing and other stuff.
And marketing.
Okay, so now you now transitioned from marketing, or you just came up with the idea Simba after what you passed through, you know, when you are tired and other stuff. You now transitioned in setting up a business that has to do with bringing convenience to people. So like, how has it been running your branding business and also running Simba, and then also being a final year student, like?
Okay, it is never easy.
Yeah.
It is not easy. It was never easy, and I praise you. But what happened was this. Now, initially, till now, why this? I help brands stand out in their marketplace.
Yeah.
So I more like I brand businesses down to, I help them scale on the internet, ranging from branding to marketing to standing out. Anything that can make them increase sales and visibility online.
Yeah.
That's what I do for businesses.
Yeah.
So, but I decided to do something now. I decided to actually bring out another extension of my business.
Okay.
because I saw that okay, it is highly required that I solve a problem in this community.
Yeah.
I featured that the problem and what I say God has given me out that mandate to actually solve that problem.
Yeah.
Because I was able to have that idea and picture that problem, so I have to solve it. So that was why I did.
Yeah.
When it comes to mixing the whole theory, it's not really easy, but I learned how to outsource.
Okay.
Outsource.
Yeah.
I also learned how to multitask, but in the tiniest ways possible, wow. so I don't overwork myself.
Yeah.
So while I'm fixing people's businesses, I'm also trying to oversee how things is going.
Yeah.
I'm also looking for how to attract investors. Yeah. Then lastly, I'm also graduating in the next few months. So I'm just running out of my few school stuff.
Awesome. So let's talk about schooling. So we are right here in Imo State University.
Yes.
Lots of things are happening in school and all that stuff. And you know this school.
Weird school.
So now, you know, like when it comes to schooling in Nigeria, the educational system is bad. Let's not spell our country outside it. But like the educational system is not really good.
Yeah.
So would you say most of the things you have learned in school played a role in your entrepreneurship journey? Or would you say most of the things you know about entrepreneurship was gotten outside of school?
Okay, 100% of what I am doing currently was not gotten from school. 100% of it. Actually, to be frank with you, I'm studying medical biochemistry or biochemistry, which has nothing to do with marketing, IT
marketing or branding and all that.
What spurred me to move into marketing, branding and these whole business was the urge to create a change in the environment.
Yeah.
Was the urge to actually make sure that I bring up something that can actually effect change or correct the disorder in the environment and help brands grow.
Yeah.
So I took courses, I unlearned, I kept on learning till now. But then why I am not just learning, but I am also implementing.
That was
a major thing that made me move into this was that I saw that okay, if I'm to graduate in this in this department now, highest that it will get me is a job in one of the most urban hospitals or clinics in the States.
150k salary.
Trust me, it's not even up to
150k.
At least it's up to me. If the help is 30,000 now. So, but then I decided to actually work more to make myself stand out.
So me personally, I find it difficult finding like-minded individuals right here in school.
Yes.
But for me personally, I'll say again that schooling, all the things I know about marketing, business, entrepreneurship, none of it was gotten from school.
Yeah.
So my main goal of being in school actually is to build up my network.
Yeah.
Understand? So would you say that's also one of the things you have as your goal, being a student here?
So to be frank with you, being in school is just for the certificate. I never got a network.
Okay.
No network. I didn't see you choose.
Yeah.
When it comes to school, I didn't get any network through school.
Yeah.
But one thing that actually changed my life in school was meeting a community of people.
Okay.
So I met this community of people. It's called Radio and Ruling 5.
Okay.
So it was from there I got to meet some few. Minds that had knowledge in this whole IT aspect. So I just had to humble myself in that community and learn. And one most enticing thing about that is that whole community, I found the community in school,
okay,
but they were not, if I say, school minded.
Okay.
They were basically God-minded.
God-minded.
So I just had to just leverage on that community, learn, grow, and get to know God better, and also get to grow my skills. And then from there, I just kept on working on myself.
Wow, that was awesome. I think I've been sitting down for a long time. Let's just walk around that.
Okay, all right.
So, like, at the moment now, what would you say are the major issues you're facing in regards to running Simba?
Okay, I'll basically say, first of all, is that we're having issues with, I won't call it a major issue, but I would say it's a sign of growth.
Okay.
So we are currently calling for investors because now we've seen how profitable the brand is. We've tested it in our environment, in our locality, both the rural areas in the state.
Yeah.
And it's highly profitable, and we've run surveys in other areas and we've seen that it's highly profitable.
Business.
Yeah, the brand.
Okay, the brand.
Highly profitable. That's Simba.
Yeah.
So what we are doing now is that we are calling for investors.
Yeah.
So which can actually help us skyrocket the brand.
Yeah.
That's one. Then secondly is that we are calling for more human resources.
Okay.
That wants to employ more people.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I can get more people involved with the brand.
It's okay. So being an entrepreneur in Nigeria, we know that there are lots of problems we have, you know, in the country.
Yes, yes.
So I would love to know, would you say Nigeria is a good country to do business or is not a good country to do business? I know this is a basic question, like, but I also want to know from your own perspective. Yeah.
To be frank with you, right from last year, I planned to leave this country by December. Because but then that was before I figured out Simba.
Yeah.
But Nigeria and Africa has lots of problems, and it's a platform for young guys to bring up ideas that can change things in this country and in Africa at large.
Yeah.
So I feel that the country has lots of bright people.
Yeah,
has lots of bright people, but we lack policies.
Okay, policies.
We lack policies that can actually help us work and grow towards stardom.
Yeah,
and then towards being impactful. So I would say that it's a good place to do business, but we urge the government to do better.
As in
better than we are seeing currently.
Yeah,
we need them to do, because now we have most currently we lack access to basic amenities.
Yeah.
That can help us work as business people, as young guys doing business. We lack access to basic amenities, basic funds that can help us grow. So I feel they should work better.
So what are your hobbies now? Like, what do you like doing now?
Business.
Drinking water is your hobby.
Yeah.
Don't need to go swimming.
Don't mind me. Alright.
Yeah.
So my hobby basically is one is swimming, which if they okay. One is my hobby is currently let me think about
it. You know your hobby, guy.
Let me think about
businessman.
So basically my hobbies are
you're on camera. I'm going to put this on though. I'm serious.
Wait, okay.
Not like swim, playing games, all those kind of things.
To be frank with you, I don't like but I like traveling. Because it's actually shapes my whole mindset.
Yeah.
Going to see new places, going on holidays, that is my major hobby. So over there, if you have to play football, it's awesome. But majorly, is going on holiday.
I want to ask you that crazy question.
Who was it?
When do you plan to marry?
Alright, so let us now move to our aspect.
Okay, another aspect. Let's leave that one. Where do you see yourself like 5 years from now? Let me not go 10 years, but like, even though you don't have any plans, but what do you think you're going to be doing here?
In the next 5 years, first of all, is that I see Simba being a renowned brand in Nigeria.
Yeah.
I see Simba being a very, also having a very large customer base.
Yeah.
That was on them. So we have targets.
Okay.
So I plan on meeting up to 7 targets.
Okay.
Out of the 10 long-term targets.
Is this something
that
you can share? This target, is this something you can share?
It's not this target I can share. We also plan on growing a tech platform.
Okay.
So this tech platform aims at helping SMEs, most young startups, to actually leverage on our advertising and marketing to be able to project them into limelight.
Okay.
But for Simba, we also aim at having a large customer base, being one of the most sought after brand when it comes to convenience in Nigeria and Africa at large.
I think that's good. That's good. So, any final advice or like is there any final thing you want to say in regards to maybe any youngster watching this video? Or let me say, someone is outside the country now that is looking at making investments. You think that that's something they should do? Probably investing in your own business.
Yes.
Yeah, like you said earlier, you said you're looking for investors.
Yes, definitely. Yes. So, okay. One thing is that currently, any person, you know, one thing that we've seen that when it comes to Nigeria, Nigeria is a place that has is a country that actually has lots of opportunities.
Yeah.
So we've been able to pick reach out a problem, and we decided to leverage on this problem to create a solution. And so this, the brand is a very good brand to invest in. It's highly profitable, and
we have highly profitable,
and it has a good profit margin. And one of the things that we also one thing that we love doing is that we like when it comes to health, we have also created an avenue where we can take people's health into consideration by giving them expert advice when it comes to their health, the kind of meals they eat, the kind of groceries we should shop for them, taking cognizance of their health issues or health.
In one sentence, it's Slim Simba.
Okay, Simba is a convenience brand. That aims at helping people live luxurious lives.
Okay. Any advice to any youngster out there that's looking at venturing into entrepreneurship?
Okay, first of all, it's not an easy something. There are times where you cry, there are times where you smile, there are times where it will be like the whole world wants to fall on top of your head. But then what I'll say is failure is inevitable. It's inevitable. Once your aim is success, failure is inevitable. I know how many things I've failed before and how many things I have passed. So one thing that entrepreneurship is one of the best things to move into. And it will be better in a country like Nigeria. I would represent to half strength because it's not easy in Nigeria currently. But consistency with the aim for excellence, I think this the sky will be the best starting point. So keep doing what you're doing, keep pushing ahead, keep having that idea, and go for it.
Thank you very much, bro.
So guys, I hope you enjoyed watching this particular video. I have other wonderful content about business, entrepreneurship, and other beautiful stuffs on my YouTube channel. So basically, you can click on the card that's showing on your screen right now to watch them, or you can also scroll through my YouTube channel to watch other wonderful YouTube videos I have made in the past. Also, please don't forget to smash the like button. Let the YouTube algorithm recommend this video to more people. There are lots of opportunities in Nigeria. So smash the like button, guys. Let the YouTube algorithm recommend this video to more people. And also, don't forget to smash the subscribe button. Let's get to 10,000 subscribers. And with that being said, guys, see you on the next one. They will know.